one word and the dark became light. I believe it, yeah. You spoke my name and my heart came to life. I believe it, yeah. I wanna sing about it. I wanna scream and shout it. My side.
Christ, the solid rock I stand. last week of January. Can you believe it? We've had so much fun talking about how strong and awesome and amazing Jesus is. He loves us so much. The Bible tells us how amazing Jesus is. Our memory verse even talks about it. Let's say it together one last time. Everyone who heard him was amazed. Luke 2:47. Let's get right to our Bible story for this morning. Now remember, God gave us the Bible and it's true. One day, Jesus and his friends were walking along a road. Now Jesus noticed something and he stopped. And do you know what Jesus saw? Jesus saw a man who was blind. That means his eyes could not see. Close your eyes for a minute. What can you see? Nothing. You can't see your friends or your mom or your dad or maybe your pet. Or if it's sunny or dark outside. Okay, you can open your eyes now. When Jesus saw the man who was blind, he did something really amazing. Jesus spit on the ground and he turned the dirt into mud. Yep, mud. Then Jesus took the mud and he put it on the man's eyes. Then Jesus told the man to go wash his face in the water. The man did what Jesus said. He went and he washed off the mud with water, and guess what? The man could see. The man was so amazed. And why? Because Jesus is amazing. Cover your eyes this time. Who's amazing? Jesus is amazing. He sure is. Now, let's close our eyes as we pray together. Jesus, we thank you that you are amazing and you did miracles, things like healing blind people so that they could see. We know that you can do amazing things in our lives. So Jesus, help us to open up our hearts and to see what you're doing in us and all around us that's amazing. I pray protection over every heart that's listening this morning. May you bless us and keep us and know that we love you. And we pray this in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thanks, my little friends. Last week in January, and I'll see you in February. Hello, everyone. It's great to see you. We've had a ton of fun this month in Kids Life. We've been playing games and finding out what it means to live with responsibility. Responsibility is showing you can be trusted with what is expected of you. Now, if you want to play any kind of game, first you need to know what rules to follow. That's how you make sure that you play fairly and responsibly. The same thing is true about the ways we choose to live life every day. We've discovered some great rules for life all throughout the Bible, which will help us play well and finish strong. Now, the Apostle Paul wrote many of the books that are in the Bible. Paul originally wrote those books as letters to believers who lived in different cities and churches. He wanted to encourage the believers to follow Jesus and live the way Jesus had taught them to live. Paul spent years teaching the church in the town of Ephesus. The book of Ephesians is actually a letter he wrote later on to the people in Ephesus. It's important to know that Paul wrote this letter when he was in prison. Paul hadn't done anything wrong, but he had gotten in trouble because some people, they were angry that he kept telling other people about Jesus. Paul wanted to remind the Ephesians what God had done for them. He wanted them to understand that if they believed in God, it should change the way that they use their words. Listen to what he wrote in Ephesians 4. Don't let any evil talk come out of your mouths. Say only what will help to build others up and meet their needs. Then what you say will help those who listen. Paul knew that this was an important topic for the believers in Ephesus, and it's super important for us too. You see, our words have a lot of power. They're probably even more powerful than we realize. For one thing, our words can build people up. Meet Ethan. Ethan just woke up and got ready for school. Before he left, his mom used her words to build him up. She used words that were nice. She chose words to encourage Ethan. She was loving and positive as she spoke to him. So Ethan got on the bus and he headed to school with lots of confidence, all because of the words that his mom chose. However, words can also tear down. When Ethan got on the bus, he sat near a couple of older kids who used their words in a really hurtful way. One of the kids was his friend, but he'd never met the other one. This other boy started saying mean things to Ethan. He was sarcastic and he said, "Cool shoes," but he didn't actually mean it. He was being dishonest, saying things about Ethan that weren't true. He was downright rude. He used his words to tear Ethan down, And by the time Ethan got off the bus, he was really discouraged. But don't worry, Ethan's day can turn around again because words can also repair. As Ethan got off the bus, the older kid who was his friend saw that he looked really upset, and he came up and told Ethan that he was sorry for not speaking up. He was truthful and honest with Ethan. He used words that were respectful. He even spoke up to the other kid who had been mean to Ethan and told him it wasn't okay to talk to his friend that way. He tried to unify the boys and bring them together. He tried to bring peace to the situation. Have you ever felt like Ethan? Has someone ever used words to build you up? Has someone used mean words to bring you down? Has someone ever apologized to try to make things right? I think all of us know how people's words can make us feel. That should make us want to choose our own words wisely. Like Paul wrote in his letter, we should use our words to build people up. We have the responsibility to choose right words that will encourage and help the people around us. That's a great rule for life and for all of us. It's our bottom line for today. Use your words wisely. You can use encouraged words with your siblings and help them feel like they can take on any challenge. You can repair a relationship by saying that you're sorry. You can unify your group of friends by saying only good things about people when they're not around. Let's use our words wisely. Let's choose words that build up and repair instead of tear down. That's not always easy, but we can do it with God's help. In fact, let's pray and talk to God right now and ask Him to help us. Jesus, we just come before you now and we recognize that our words are powerful, that our words can create life or they can cause death in other people. I pray, Lord, that we will use our words to build people up, to draw them closer to you, to encourage them and to help them know how valuable they are, and that we will not use words that tear down. I pray that you give us wisdom to know what to say and when to say it, and may all of it, Jesus, bring you glory. We love you and we're thankful for what you're teaching us, Jesus. And we pray this in your name. Amen. Thanks, kids. It was really great spending January with you, and I look forward to February. I hope you are too. Have a great Sunday.